Hi, I'm Beth and I'm a former pupil of Bishopbriggs Academy. I first came in contact with the charity last year during my YPI course. Sandy got in touch a couple of weeks ago, and at first I didn't really know what to expect. I wasn't sure what we were going to be doing. Once I got there though, and I had a chance to talk to Sandy himself, it became abundantly clear, which I'm hoping this video will show. COVID-19 has been hard on everyone, and I'm not denying that fact, but I think for a lot of people, we've forgotten how it may have affected those who are more vulnerable. So this video aims to educate, and hopefully you'll be able to share and pass on the message so that we can help resolve this issue for Sandy and others like him.
Hello folks, we're in the middle of Kirkintilloch town centre. And my name is Sandy Taylor. I chair a group of visually impaired people in the town. We have around 30 members. However, we feel rather unwelcome in the town because so many barriers have been put in our way recently that we can't access our town centre. 4 years ago, a new shared space was introduced to the town where they took away all the traffic lights and control crossings at this junction here in Catherine Street, and they took away most of our space. I'm supposed to make eye contact with cars coming along and the driver will stop. So as you can imagine, for a blind person, that's just not possible. But more recently, and again with the coronavirus, we've got other barriers put in our way because we've got to be able to socially distance or physically distance from people. Now, I'm sure you can imagine for a blind person, that's not possible. So we've been asking the council for a clear corridor, a 2 metre corridor along the building line here. The reason I say that is, as a blind person, most blind people use a long cane, and we've got to have something to follow. You can't just have an open space where you don't know where you are, quite frankly. And we use a system called mental mapping. This is where we memorise a route. We memorise all the different obstacles, if you like, or landmarks on the way. But when there are people involved and we are supposed to socially distance from them, it makes it impossible. And that's why the council actually agreed to my request for a 2 metre corridor along the building line where we can follow with a cane. However, it has not been implemented, and I'm talking 3 months ago. Now, I asked Councillor Susan Murray, who is the local councillor for this area, and Joint Council Leader Andrew Paulson for their help. They haven't responded. So I've got these two friends with me today from Bishopbriggs Academy, Grant and Beth, who have kindly agreed to take some film for you to see exactly what the problems are. Because in Eastern Dunbartonshire, there are over 4,300 visually impaired and blind people. Now, that's a lot of business to be lost by the shopkeepers in this town. So, I'm looking for your help. I'm sending this to all councillors and anybody else who will listen. This scheme here is in breach of the Equality Act. The council and councillors have a duty to make reasonable adjustments to make the town accessible for people like me. And so far, they have failed to do so. So here I am, folks, I'm following the wall along outside St. Mary's Church. And I've done this so many, many times, but invariably I've come across a barrier. There we are. There's obstructions. More obstructions. If there was somebody sitting at that table and chairs, I would not be able to socially distance from them. And that would put both me and the customer in potential danger. So here we are back at the junction again, and we're going to head north. If anyone was sitting here, I wouldn't be able to self-distance from them. And that's putting us both in danger. Now, what we should have here really is screening around these tables to protect both the customer and myself. No problem if we had a corridor along the building line where we could follow. Here we are. We've come up against
advertisement board.
Advertising boards. Back to the building line. Look, you know, we were asking for 2 metres to socially distance. And these tables and chairs should be away from the building.
Here are the tables and chairs again.
Again, if anybody was sitting there. See the problems that were created there. Now, if there was screening around those tables, I wouldn't have a problem, and neither would the people sitting there. As it is, you know, this is an oval area for me and many, many hundreds of other blind people. What we're asking for is either these tables and chairs to be moved to the outer edge next to the roadway, or give a screening around these tables and chairs. It's not a lot to be asked for, and the cost is minimal. To make reasonable adjustments to accommodate visually impaired and blind people.